my career in journalism. Years ago, I had to interview one man from the Hostess Theatre Skiff Art. So, that was my first professional journalistic task. So I phoned him and we agreed to meet in the cafe. The next day we met there. We came in and then the waitress came to us and asked if we'd like to have some coffee or tea.
Coffee please, said my acquaintance.
And what's about you? She asked me.
The same, I answered.
And since that minute, I couldn't stop asking myself, who should pay the bill? Should it be him, or should it be each of us separately? On the one hand, he was a man, and I was a girl, and I was a student, and it would be very nice for him to pay for both of us. And actually, that was his idea to meet there. But on the other hand, we had a business meeting, so according to the business etiquette rules, we had to pay separately. I couldn't think of anything else. To pay or not to pay, that was the question. And for my luck, I had written all questions before the interview, and my telephone was in the order. So I sat and thought, yeah, I could avoid this suffering if I knew some simple business etiquette rules. So let's begin with the simplest. Who is the first? The ironclad rule, ladies first, isn't important in tomorrow's official life. Sorry, today's official life. A businessman, a boss, can go ahead of the employed woman. But if he's a gentleman, he has to put them through. But of course he cannot do in such a way because, for example, when there are a lot of women opening the door. But, girls, when you're approaching a door, my advice for you is just to try to walk slower and to let him decide who is the first, who should be the first. To my experience, the man, as usual, show a gesture that means after you. But of course there are a lot of situations when the man has to go first. For example, when you are staying before the elevator in the office, man is first. He should always go first because the lift hole can break at any moment, and it's very nice of him to risk himself for a businesswoman's life. And the thing is, when they enter the dark room, because a woman can help herself with the furniture in the dark. So the man has enter first and to switch on the light. And the same is when it's dark outside and there is much snow and a man has to help her lady to walk. Another point is about greetings. For example, who should first say hello. Definitely the man is first who says hello, but it's even if he is a president of Ukraine. And he enters the room and there are ladies sitting down on the table, so they are allowed not to rise. Even their boss comes in. But for example, when there is a president or a chairman of the corporation, a woman has to rise. Another situation is about a man who are sitting in the room. When the female boss is coming, they have not only to rise, but to stand until she goes back or goes out or the dog. And about, for example, how much time do I have?
almost 2 minutes.
Okay, so about, let's talk about some situations connected with arrangements in the cafe. Sometimes we have business lunches in restaurant or in cafe. So there comes a question who should pay the bill. And there are two simple rules. It should be a man if he invites a lady who is the acquirer in rage or who is a subordinate to him. So he has to pay. When he has a lunch with his female boss, she has to pay herself. But if a female boss invites her partner, her subordinate man, or her college to the restaurant, she has to pay for everyone. It's according to the business etiquette rules. And as for me, I didn't pay 3 years ago. I don't know it was a true or false decision. Maybe it was a breach of etiquette. But to my opinion, even in business, a man should remain gentleman and a woman should remain a lady. Thank you.